What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and this video, I want to talk about the Wonder Woman game heading into 2024, the state of it, what we got from this game in 2023, and what I think is going to happen for this game in 2024. Well, there's not too much to talk about for 2023, right? Officially, it was another year of absolute silence, and that's definitely the negative way of looking at it. I think that's honestly a way of looking at it just in general, but over the last couple months, there's, I believe, signs of hope. Not that I think the game has ever been in like massive danger or canceled or anything like that, but the last couple months I feel like we've almost entered into a new phase, right? First it started with the concept art. Actually, there's a couple concept art pictures, and so what I guess I'm saying is we're almost in like the leak and rumor territory for Wonder Woman. And it's a weird, you know, territory to be in, but over the last couple months, you know, we got the job postings, which I guess I kind of like broke that story, you know, on the internet, the live service element, maybe not. Now they took that away, future, like after that happened, they took that part out of future job posts that they had. So, you know, whether this game is going to have some sort of, you know, microtransaction or something like that, we really don't know. Now you can judge that how you want, and you know, we've talked about that, but that was one thing that happened. And again, like, is that official? Is that not official? Well, we did get them kind of coming out and saying, you know, this is going to be a single player open. They almost reiterated what this game is going to be. So that's good to hear, you know, at the very least. We had Special Nick, who came out just maybe like a month and a half, 2 months ago, talking about some like legitimate rumors of how this game is going to actually play and different mechanics in this game. Now, he's not the most reliable person on planet Earth. He's definitely gotten things right for sure. But I guess, again, to reiterate where we're at, we're there. We're at the point where I think over the next maybe half year, we start to get more rumors, more leaks of this game. Because, and the reason that's good news, at least to me, that means we're closer. Normally, like, if you're going to do a leak of a game that's like 5 years out, it's going to be very, very surface level. And you know, of course, you have a 50-50 shot of it being true or not, but it's going to be very surface level leaks. Now, you can start to literally get into the nitty gritty. Maybe we get some like villains. Maybe we get more core mechanics of the actual game. Now, okay, well, this is just rumors and just leaks. Well, what about like official info? Well, again, like, in that way, this year was incredibly, you know, again, I guess, disappointing, right? We don't get anything. 2024, and I'm going to say this, and I mean, this could definitely come back to bite me. We'll do this again, you know, next December, and we can kind of, you know, recap if I was right or wrong. I think 2024 is going to be a pretty good year for this game. Is it going to release? No. However, you know, if you wanted to try to convince me that this game has a shot, I might listen to you. I really don't think it's coming out in 2024, but I think, you know, when you think to, is 2024 a filler year, right? Compared to 2025, GTA, maybe Kingdom Hearts, Persona, Wonder Woman. See, I think Wonder Woman is a 2025 game, which kind of helps the argument of like 2025 is massive and 24 is not as big. I think it's going to be 2025. So what does that mean for, you know, the upcoming year? Well, I think this is when you start to get info. Not too much. You look at how WB has been doing things with Suicide Squad, with Gotham Knights, with Hogwarts Legacy. These are all actually really good examples. One thing is they normally aren't revealing stuff super, super far out. Okay, so and what I mean by that is if Wonder Woman is coming out, say, fall of 25, you are not, I think, at least in the first half of the year, for sure, of 24, you are not going to get any big deep dive and as to how the game actually works. You could say, well, Alex, they did that with Suicide Squad. And that's true, but remember, Suicide Squad has been delayed multiple times, right? So when they went all in, when they really showed Suicide Squad off, even from a gameplay perspective, they thought that game was coming out, let's say, within like a 12-month radius, right? They've done it with Hogwarts. As you get closer, they showed us quite a bit. I mean, we got loads of info on Hogwarts Legacy. We got loads of info on Gotham Knights, right? So that's one part of this where I wouldn't expect, at least in the first half of 2024, I would basically not expect almost anything, and we'll get there in a second. And I guess the second part to that would be, okay, well, what about this almost taking turns approach they have? And I think that's important. So Hogwarts Legacy didn't play by that same rule, right? Because that was more the Wizarding World versus, you know, DC. But what seems to be happening, and I think it's kind of been proven with Gotham Knights, now Suicide Squad, and then Wonder Woman, you know, after it, they almost do seem to be taking turns, right? Suicide Squad, again, like, they showed a little bit when Gotham Knights was going, you know, through its kind of arc, but very, very little, okay? And I think this is what we're seeing literally in real time right now. Right now, it's all Suicide Squad. And do you hear anything from Wonder Woman? No, you only get it through rumors and leaks. So I do believe this taking turn kind of approach is what they're doing for these single player Gotham Knights and actually Suicide Squad. You can play with more than one, right? But this, the kind of genre they're in, they're kind of waiting for each other. So I do believe, and I mean, I've said this before, Suicide Squad comes out and then the floodgates kind of open. I truly believe that. And you know, I'm going to make other videos for other games. I don't think it's just Wonder Woman. I think you could see something on a Superman game in 2024. I think WB Montreal's second game, the one that they were working on kind of with Gotham Knights, you know, separate from it, I think that game could be announced. And maybe that is the Superman game, but I think 2024 could be a year of a couple new DC games getting announced. But then you push one of them, and obviously which one do you push? You push the next one in line, which would be Wonder Woman. So that's really what I think. I think the first couple months, you get nothing, right? I mean, you get rumors if that happens. You get maybe more leaked artwork or job postings. Like, those are valid ways, right, of finding out something about this game. And I think as the year goes on, this is a prime candidate to get, like, a really big kind of trailer. Now, honestly, that's kind of what I would expect from it. If you're talking about maybe Summer Game Fest, if you're talking about, I mean, really, the Jeff Keighley shows, like, is that too, like, I'm copping out there. But at the end of the day, he showed Wonder Woman. He's done so many, like, a lot of his shows have had Suicide Squad in it, so it would make sense. So if you want to say, you know, June or sometime over the summer, or then the Game Awards, you know, next December, I think those make sense to show Wonder Woman. And I don't think you would get the most massive, you know, gameplay deep dive. I think that would be closer, right, as you get close. Even, like, you look at what Suicide Squad is doing right now, right? So I think that's kind of how it would go. You'd get a trailer. It would definitely show off more of what this game actually is, because up until this point, you know, we can hear about what it is, and the trailer that they gave is next to nothing, right? So I think you got to give a big, you know, 2-3 minute trailer that really shows us what this game is, and then as you get closer, you can do the deep dives and the gameplay and all that jazz. And that might be more of a 2025 thing. Depends on when it comes out, right? If it comes out in the spring of 25, well, or even like, say, an Arkham Knight kind of territory, right, like June. Well, if it does that, then, okay, well, maybe Game Awards next year, maybe you could do, you know, gameplay, because it's only 6 months out at that point. But if this is a October or November, you know, of 25 thing, where it's basically 2 years away, even from right now, you're not going to, even next year, a year from now, you still probably wouldn't show all that much. So are we going to get something for this game? I honestly predict we will in 24. Is it going to be all of it? No. At least, again, my prediction. Are we going to get the game next year? No. It's Suicide Squad's turn, right? And that's just, I think, how it's gone. But I really think, again, like I said, not just Wonder Woman. I think DC, hopefully, I mean, you could pray, right, could maybe have a pretty good year in 24 with announcements and just, you know, kind of signaling what this new age, which hopefully means just more DC games in general, right? We need more of these. You could say whatever you want about certain of the Marvel stuff, but they're pumping them out left and right. They're going out. They're going crazy. DC very slow. So they got to turn that around. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel, bell icon turned on. Obviously, I'll be covering Wonder Woman whenever it pops up. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all on the next one.